Hello everyone, this is Mark with Accelerate Games. I am back with my episode of Heavy Rain, continuing right where I left off, where Ethan is in the garage with the first challenge from the serial killer, Origami Killer. And so, I took a little detour with Telltale's Minecraft episode 5, as well as The Walking Dead Michonne. And so, both those came out, so I had to get those uploaded, you know, instead of brand new. So, but now I'm back to my regular schedule program, friends.
Your destination is 4 miles from here. Leave the parking lot and take the first right. In order to save your son, listen carefully. Take the highway and drive against the traffic for 5 miles. If you haven't reached your destination in 5 minutes, you will have failed.
I can do it. I'd do anything to save my son. Can't stop my hands shaking. I'm not going to make it. I'm not going to make it! I don't want to die. Not here. Not like this. If I succeed, I'll get more letters for the hangman. It's my only lead. No turning back now. I've got to do it. For Sean's sake. I have no choice.
You still have 3 miles to go before you reach your destination. reward is in the glove compartment. The key is inside the GPS. Your reward is in the glove compartment. The key is inside the GPS.
Funny there for a second. I thought I wasn't gonna make it though. That was definitely a close call though.
I'd like a room.
For you? Anything. Feeling the register. Madison Page, 27. Single. How long will you be staying with us, Ms. Page?
I don't know yet.
Room 201. Last floor, stairs on the right in the courtyard.
Thanks.
The pleasure was all mine.
That's for sure.
sir? Are you all right? I'll call an ambulance.
No ambulance.
You're badly hurt. You need a doctor.
Please, just help me to my room. It's number 207.
Have you got the key? You're really in bad shape. You should see a doctor.
Must have one, maybe two broken ribs. It's not fatal. But it's sore as hell.
Your head is bleeding. It looks deep. Paraphenol anti-fever. Administer only in cases of high fever. Paraphenol anti-fever. Administer only in cases of high fever. Here. Take this. It should do you some good.
What is it?
It'll help bring down the fever.
But I'm, not running a fever.
Okay, I'll see if I can find anything else. I should disinfect his cuts. I'm gonna disinfect your wound. This might hurt a little. There. At least it won't get infected.
Thanks.
Necafrin 100 antibiotics, administered to combat infection. Here, take this. It should do you some good.
What is it?
It's an antibiotic.
An antibiotic? I'm no doctor, but I don't think there's any risk of infection with a broken rib.
Okay, I'll see if I can find anything else.
Listen, thanks for your help, but I think I can take it from here.
Right. I better go.
By the way, I'm Ethan.
Madison.
Why didn't you shoot?
Sorry?
Well, back there, Nathaniel could have had a gun. Could have killed me. Why didn't you shoot?
I prefer to have all the information before I make a decision. I try to make rational choices when possible.
Come on, you had a fraction of a second to react. You could have whacked me before you had time to move.
Oh, I'm sorry. I thought you were a tough guy. A street cop who's been through the mill. I didn't think you'd scare so easily.
Why don't you fuck off, Norman?
That's him.
Miroslav Korda?
Yeah?
Lieutenant Carter Blake, I'd like to ask you some questions.
Shit, don't just stand there, he's gonna get away! Hey man, watch it, dude!
This time it looks like we got our origami killer.
Mm.
You said I could contact you if I remembered anything. Can I come in?
Sure. Please, take a seat.
I just remembered something. Maybe it's not important, but a letter arrived in the mail the morning Johnny disappeared.
A letter? What kind of a letter?
It was addressed to Johnny's father. I don't know what was inside it, but he read it and then he left. That's the last time I saw him.
And you think there's a connection between that letter and Johnny's death, is that it? Do you remember anything else about the letter?
Well, I don't know why, but I kept the envelope.
It was mailed in the Carnaby district the day before Johnny disappeared. No sender. Nothing particular. Except the address.
The address?
It was typed with an old typewriter. Could be a lead, you never know. Well, thanks for your help, Lauren. I'll let you know if it leads to anything.
Wait, I can't just sit around and do nothing while you're out there looking for the man who killed my son. Ever since you came around, I've been thinking, and I want to come with you. Help you in your investigation?
There's nothing you can do to help, Lauren. It's not a good idea. Believe me.
If you won't let me help you, I'm keeping the envelope. It's all or nothing.
I'm sorry, Lauren, but I work alone.
How many clues have you got, Mr. Shelby? This envelope. Maybe your only link to the killer. I understand. It was a stupid idea. Sorry for wasting your time, Mr. Shelby.
Wait. You're really something special, Lauren. I'll give you that.
I'm just a mother. A mother who wants to find out who killed her son. Are we partners?
We're partners. Maybe you better stay in the car.
We're partners, remember? Wherever you go, I go. What are we doing here?
We come to see Gordy Kramer.
Kramer? The bigwig tycoon from Kramer Construction.
No, his son.
You think maybe he's the Origami Killer?
For now, I just have a few questions that need answers. Kramer's decor another time.
Are we gonna be here long? This place gives me the creeps.
I'm gonna go find Gordy Kramer. You stay here till I come back. Okay?
Okay. Just let me know if you need me.
Hi. I'd like to see Gordy.
Gordy isn't seeing anyone. Beat it.
Here's Mr. Franklin. He says I should go up.
You talk so crazy if I shove that wallet down your throat? Beat it! I ain't for sale.
If I want to see Gordy Kramer, I'm gonna have to go about it some other way.
Whoa. You see that guy over there? Do you know what he said about you?
What'd he say?
The bastard! Ah, sort him out! You motherfucker!
Were you talking about my mother, you great monkey in a cheap suit? You think, you think you're a big man. I'm a bigger man than you. Ah, you just know. Hey. Monkey, I'm talking to you, you big ape. What are you saying about my monkey? You get wild with me, my little friend. And you, do you know who I am?
Mr. Kramer?
Shh! This is the best part!
My name is Scott Shelby. I'm a private detective. I'm investigating the case of the Origami Killer. I'd like to ask you a few questions. I'd like to know exactly what happened to little Joseph Brown.
Beat it! You hear me? Get the hell out of here!
What do you want?
A witness saw little Joseph Brown get in the back of your limousine. That was the last time anybody ever saw him. Now, I know you've been arrested and interrogated until your father made a little phone call and the file was closed. I'd like to hear your version of the facts.
The kid was lost. I just offered to drive him home. The police arrived, I explained the misunderstanding, and I was released. End of story. Nothing to get excited about, right?
Okay, so you're a good Samaritan, taking kids home who happen to get lost right next to your limousine? Now be a nice guy and tell me something I can believe.
Very well. I'm the Origami Killer. I get my victims into my car. I drown them in rainwater. Then I dump them on a wasteland with an origami figure in one hand and an orchid on their chest. I do that because I'm bored, Mr. Shelby. And it's a creative and entertaining way of having fun. Is that good enough for you? Or do you want more? This interview is over.
Get rid of this clown!
It's a dangerous game you're playing, Kramer.
Do you know who my father is? He only has to lift one finger and you won't wake up tomorrow morning. You're the one that should be afraid, Mr. Shelby. Not me.
Glass. Broken glass. Sharp as a razor. Impossible to go back. I'm gonna have to crawl through it, slowly, so I don't tear up my arms. Match flame. It indicates where the fresh air comes from. All I have to do is follow the wind. Thank you.
To jump or not to jump? Fuck that.
Right. I guess I don't really have any choice. Thank you.
Oh my god. Ethan. Ethan, can you hear me? Origami figures. What is he doing with them? Are those burn marks on your chest? I'm gonna have to get your clothes off to disinfect those wounds. A doctor, but I'll do what I can. Crap, that's disinfectant. Not terribly good for burns. Your wounds are disinfected. That should ease the pain. Thank you.
That's all I can do. How do you feel? Ethan?
He's unconscious. Now I'll just have to wait. And hope he wakes up.
How do you feel?
I've been better. Was I out for long?
About 3 hours.
Why the Guardian Angel act? You don't even know me.
When I was a child, I was always the one who used to fix my brothers up when they'd been fighting with the other kids on the block. I suppose I like to play the guardian angel.
You said you were here because you're an insomniac?
I've been going through a bit of a tough patch the last few months. It's the kind of stuff you prefer to forget. I do what I can to live with it, but, it's not easy. That's the second time I found you in a bad way. You always seem to be running for your life. What's happening, Ethan? You mixed up with the mafia? Owe someone money? Something like that?
Listen, I'm truly grateful for your help, but for your own sake, I think it's better if you don't ask any questions.
Maybe I could help you.
No one can help me. You've already done a lot, Madison.
Right. I'm gonna go. Take care.
I didn't do it. I swear I didn't do it. I've got nothing to do with that business. I never killed nobody.
Oh, no? Then why did you run away when they came to question you?
I already told you I forgot to report to my parole officer. I didn't want to go back to prison. When I saw the cops, I just bolted. I wasn't thinking straight.
We checked out his statement. He has an alibi for at least 3 of the murders.
Fuck, that bastard was a perfect fit. Shit!
Ash? Okay. Sean Moss's mother is here. She'd like to speak with you.
It was a few months back, the middle of the night. It was pouring down. Ethan came home completely drenched at about 3. I asked him where he'd been. He spoke about drowning, the rain. He didn't make any sense. There was something. Something in his eyes. As if it wasn't really him. There may be no connection, but the next day there was that announcement about another victim of the Origami Killer. Find my son. I'm begging you.
Police Lieutenant Carter Blake, and this is Agent Norman Jaden of the FBI. According to our information, Ethan Mars is one of your patients. We'd like to ask you a few questions about him.
I'm sorry, that's impossible.
I beg your pardon?
I'm bound by an oath of secrecy. Under no circumstances may I discuss my patients.
My job is to find Sean Mars alive, and I don't give a damn about any bullshit oath.
It's your duty to inform the police if you suspect one of your patients, Doctor.
I'm sorry. I can't help you. And now I must ask you to leave.
You need to cooperate. For your own sake.
Sean Mars's life may depend on what you know. Tell us what you know, Doctor.
Are you threatening me?
I'm just giving you some free advice, Doc. I suggest you take it.
Blake, that's enough. Let's get out of here.
I am going to call the police and make a complaint about your behavior.
Doctor, you are really pushing my buttons. The only thing I'm interested in is saving that kid's life. So, you're gonna be a good boy and tell me what I want to know, or I am really gonna lose my temper.
What are you doing? You out of your mind?
Back off, Jaden. This guy knows something, and I'm not leaving here until he tells me what it is.
You have no right!
Come on, Doc. There's an easy way and a hard way. It's your fucking choice.
You have no right to hit him.
I'm saving a kid's life for Christ's sake. If you don't like it, leave. What's up with you, Norm? Are you getting cold feet? You don't like to get your hands dirty, huh? I thought you wanted to save that kid!
I want to save Sean Mars just as much as you do, but that doesn't give me the freedom to do what the hell I like, so you're gonna stop this shit right now!
I'll get you for this, Jaden. Don't worry. I will not forget!
Ethan Mars has had psychological problems since his first son died. Feels responsible for his death. A sort of morbid neurosis. He is haunted by visions of drowning bodies. A few weeks ago, after one of our usual sessions, I found this on the floor. It must have fallen out of his pocket.
Ash, I want you to assign every available man to finding Ethan Mars. I want a man outside his place day and night. Notify all agencies to start looking for him. I want you to keep an eye on the train stations, the airports, the bus terminals. I want every cop in the city on his ass, so that if he moves, we know about it. Yes, Ethan Mars is the Origami Killer.
All right, I am going to go to end it right here. I want to thank you guys for watching. Please like, comment, or subscribe, and I will see you guys next in the next Heavy Rain Good Choice playthrough. Thank you.